When companies need to cut spending, many cut ad dollars first. With times getting tough, the ad agency's taking a hit. Frederick Karlstrom is the CEO of Great Works America, the ad agency, marketing agency, joining us now. And you just got this job as the CEO and creative director.
I did.
You came out of movie making.
I did. Well, I have a long tradition. I used to work in advertising, and then I started producing film, and then I got sort of suckered back into advertising.
What a time to get suckered back in. Is it a blessing, you think?
I think so. I think that we're in a position, Great Works is in a position that we're where we're actually, you're talking about the cutting spending. We haven't really seen that as much because we work a lot on digital, mm-hmm. On the digital space. And so we see actually an increase in spending.
Do you only work in digital? Do you only work, I guess, when you say digital, do you mean online and also other types of, say, mobile advertising? Are you also seeing an opportunity to dip your foot in the water with traditional media?
We work with all our brands globally, and we focus on digital, mm-hmm. but we do some traditional stuff as well. But we're, you know, online, mobile, all types of digital platforms we work with.
Well, talk to me then about online ad spending, because growth there has shown some signs of slowing. Is it certain types of ads? Are companies, the advertisers, just being more particular about what they do and where they place ads?
What we do differently as opposed to traditional advertising agencies is that we try to spend more money developing content, mm-hmm. As opposed to sort of buying media, mm-hmm. Which a lot of so I think there's a shift from media spend to developing content. So we don't really see that big a difference because we're not really buying media. So on that end, we don't see it. But
What will your approach do that, say, just kind of the traditional thinking about advertising do for a company?
Well, I think the technology overall, and internet in particular, has made a huge change for people. So for ordinary viewers and readers of consumers of media, we don't have to consume advertising. We don't have to be interrupted by advertising if we don't want to, which means, obviously, it's a new world for brands that want to advertise. There's a new world for advertising agencies that need to communicate, and there's a new world for publishers of media companies like Fox that are losing ad revenue. And I think what the benefit of this is, as a brand, as a marketer, you have to be interested. You have to say something that is interesting to people so that they actually want to spend time with your brand. And we think that it's less effective to sort of just make an ad and wave it in people's face. As opposed to doing something that people actually want to spend time with.
Give me what you think is the most effective, I guess, type of content you've seen, or even a traditional ad, by a company that you don't work for, that you don't do work for. Is there anything that you saw recently that just jumped out at you and you said they really get it?
Well, I think there's many. I think they're looking at industries. I think that the movie industry and the TV industry, to some extent, are pretty good at using aspirational and sort of building a buzz and building awareness through untraditional channels. I think they're very good at it. I think the fashion industry is pretty good at, even though I sometimes think that there are other people that create the aspiration and the want and the need for things. And so, to be specific, I don't know.
Because I know you spend your whole life online for the most part, don't you?
Online and offline. But, I mean, I think that the recent, I don't know, I can't give
you. Have you been paying attention at all to the commercials from Barack Obama and, I guess, to a little greater extent, John McCain with the kind of now famous celebrity ad with Barack Obama,
right.
Paris Hilton, and Britney Spears?
Yeah, I mean, I think. The technology, what applying that to the presidential debate and the campaigns is interesting because for the first time, I think maybe ever, there's a collective memory that is amazing. You know, you can stand up and say, you know, as a politician, and say, I don't want, you know, offshore drilling is not a good thing, and then you change your mind a week later, which we see happening all the time. All of a sudden there's clips on YouTube and there's clips online and people remember what you've said. So I think honesty and transparency is incredibly important, not only for brands, but for, I mean, in a way, Obama and McCain are brands, and they need to be honest and transparent. And I think not being that will bite them in the back.
And politics and in business. It was great to see you.
Thank you very much.
As you pointed out, thank you so much, Frederick Karlstrom with Great Works America. He's the CEO and creative officer, creative chief. Thank you so much
for
being here.